Hi, I'm Kanish Chauhan.
And I'm Mohammad Moiz Gaur.
Our topic of presentation is where to invest money in energy saving technologies or elsewhere, a decision support tool.
So this is the basic outline. We'll start with motivation and problem statement. Then we'll move over to the implementation, which includes two approaches. One is simulation based approach and the other is model checking approach. And finally we'll see the results of the two approaches, and then we'll have a comparison, look at the comparison. In this work, we are concerned with energy aware technologies, example smart lighting, which help us in reducing energy consumption, but there is also associated with it a high cost of installation and maintenance, which leads to the investment dilemma, that is, whether should I invest in smart technology or should I invest my money elsewhere, for example banking or fixed deposit or stocks.
In order to resolve the dilemma, we should know the awareness of building user. By awareness, we mean whether you are conscious enough to switch off their devices when they are leaving or not. So why does their consciousness or awareness matter? If the users are very aware to switch off their devices before leaving, then we can invest in banking or anywhere else. Otherwise, you can deploy smart technologies. So how we are quantifying the awareness of users? By calculating the average probability of occupant of switching off their devices or not. And there are several ways to measure this. First one is temporary installation of sensors and monitoring devices. Second one is log details of various devices like laptops, desktops, monitors.
In our work, we have considered the scenario of an office environment, considering 3 rooms and 6 persons, but this could also be scaled to a larger number of rooms or a larger number of persons. Before we move on to the approach, let us have a look at some of the assumption. A day is split into 3 events, with the event 1 being coming to office, that is from 7 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. Event 2 is walking around in the office, that is moving from one room to another, that is from 8:30 a.m. to 5 in the evening. And event 3 is returning back to home, which is 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. And the information regarding the occupancy of each person at each time step is collected at the end of 10 minute interval, which is called a time step. So a total of 84 time steps are there, from 7 a.m. in the morning to 9 p.m. in the evening. Also, the energy being consumed is proportional to the number of users in that room, and the savings when smart technologies is deployed versus when they are not is determined by the gap, which is the number of persons leaving a room and not switching off the device.
So the first approach is simulation based approach.
The simulation based approach is implemented using Java program, to which the inputs are as follows. First is the number of rooms in the building. Second is assignment of the users to an initial location. The third is the transition matrices, which denote the probability of movement of a person from one room to another. Fourth input is the average probability P of each user of switching of their devices, and lastly the input is the number of time steps, which is the total number of time steps. The approach is to generate an occupancy profile for each user, which will tell us whether a particular user is in a particular room at a particular time step. Also, each user is assigned a priority P, which denotes the priority of him or her switching off the devices when they leave the room. So we are interested in those time intervals when the person leaves the room and forgets to switch off the device being used, because power would have been saved in this interval if smart technology had been deployed.
Here you can see initial location vector A, and the corresponding entry is 1 corresponding to location 2. That means initial location of person is in room 2, so that is k equal to 2. And you can see P matrix, which is in the movement probabilities corresponding to location I to location j. So now you are simply multiplying initial location vector with the matrix P to get the transition probabilities distribution, which is C. Now how you are predicting the next location j, you are simply calculating the cumulative matrix. We are calling it as C prime, and sum should be 1. So you can see entry corresponding to location 1 is 0.30, 2 to 0.70, and 3 to 1.0. Suppose previous location is k, that is room 2, and now you are generating a random number between 0 to 1 and you are checking whether it is less than C prime j, then your next location will be j. Based on particular run of program, we got the room 1 occupancy profile, which denotes the number of users present in that room at particular instant of time. Recall that gap that denotes number of person leaving a room at particular time step, and suppose they forget to switch off their devices. So how we are calculating? This is the formula: power saved per room per time step if smart technology has been installed equal to number of person leaving a location minus number of person switching off their devices into W, where W is average power consumed by one device in one time step.
So this is the energy profile obtained after running the simulation for 100 times and with different values of P. By saving, we mean those time steps in which the user forgets to switch off their devices while leaving the room. As we can see, for lower values of P, the energy saved is quite high as compared to higher values of P. In the previous slide, we have seen the energy saved, which was in terms of time steps. In this slide, we'll see how those time steps convert into money. So with the initial investment and the cost per unit and number of units consumed and the average wattage per device, as shown, the average one day savings comes out to be the power consumption corresponding to the number of time steps in which the power wasn't switched off when not in use. So here is a comparison of savings obtained due to smart technology deployment and that obtained after investing the money elsewhere for 5 years with certain rate of interest. We have green cells and red cells. The green cells denote that we should go for smart technology deployment because the energy saved due to smart technology deployment exceeds that obtained after investing the money elsewhere. Whereas the red cells denote that we should not go for smart technology because the savings obtained from smart technology deployment is less than that obtained after investing the money elsewhere. So let us have a look at the advantages and disadvantages of this approach. The advantages are that it is scalable, that is we can increase the number of rooms and the number of persons and we can still run the program efficiently, and it is easy to implement. But there are also at least certain disadvantages. One is accuracy depends on the number of simulations performed. That means if we require higher accuracy, then we have to perform a large number of simulations, and it can only be used to answer straightforward properties. For example, it is not easy to answer queries like what is the probability of saving P amount of money in certain amount of time when we use smart technology.